Welcome back to the channel. This is Wei Hao at Direct Impact Solutions. In the last web integration video, we introduced basic authentication, allowing us to call other methods provided by the web service we are integrating with. If you recall, one of the curl parameters we need to specify is the request parameter. In the previous video, we used the value post, but did not elaborate on this parameter and what other options are there. So in this video, we will introduce different HTTP request types, or commonly known as HTTP verbs, and provide you with a few examples of how they are used within the FileMaker admin API. Some examples we will use are options that cannot be configured via the FileMaker server admin console anymore, but can still be accessed via the admin API. So keep watching until the end of the video to unlock this hidden configuration options within FileMaker server. There are two popular API types we will likely work with, one being SOAP, the other one being REST. If you need to tell SOAP APIs apart from REST APIs, a very simplified rule of thumb is that those who use XML are SOAP and those who use JSON are REST. This is not 100% accurate, but works most of the time. For SOAP APIs, 99% of the time, POST is the only method you would use. You would use it to create, read, update, and delete data. I will create a separate video to discuss how to approach a SOAP integration project in the future. In today's video, let's focus on REST. For REST APIs, different HTTP verbs will be used for different types of operations. Let me answer the most obvious question right here. How do I tell which method I should use for a certain request? Well, for REST APIs, this is usually part of their documentation. But what if I'm working with an under-documented API? Either there's not enough documentation or the documentation is outdated. This happens quite often, especially when you are integrated with some highly customized professional software instead of a publicly accessible service. In this case, keep watching. The rest of the video will give you a general sense of which method you should be using for certain type of requests. Let's start with POST. For REST APIs, POST is most often used for creation. For example, in our previous basic authentication example, we submitted our credential to the FileMaker admin API to create an access token. That's why that request is a POST request. When the POST request is successful, it usually returns information regarding the resource you just created. In our basic authentication example, it returns the access token itself. With some other APIs, it might tell you how many records have been created successfully. One thing to note with POST is that if you POST the same request twice, you will likely create something twice. The second call will not automatically update your first creation. Again, with the basic authentication example, you can see the server created another access token for me if I rerun it. If we draw a similarity with a FileMaker feature, POST is very similar to the add option when importing records. Let's move on to GET. GET is mostly used for read or retrieve info. A good example of GET within the FileMaker admin API is the ability to retrieve a list of connected clients using the listClients method. When a GET request is successful, it returns a JSON containing the information you queried. Calling the same GET request once has the same effect as calling it 100 times or none at all. Note, we're talking about having the same effect, not having the same return. For example, The listClients method will always give you a list of connected clients every time you call it. But since clients can connect and disconnect, you might get a different list the next time you call it. Next, I'm going to talk about put and patch together. Both are typically used for updates. The difference is that a put request usually asks you to provide all the information of the data resource you're trying to update and use it to replace the original, while a patch request only needs to contain the changes instead of the complete resource. If we draw a similarity with the FileMaker feature, put is similar to the replace option, while patch is similar to the update option when importing records. There are actually no put requests under the FileMaker admin API, however, there are many patch requests. For example, you can enable PHP web publishing using a patch request called update PHP settings. This is an option that cannot be configured via the admin console. So, if you do PHP custom web publishing, it's actually pretty convenient to have your own configuration module to configure your PHP setting. The last verb we're going to talk about today is delete. As the name suggests, it is used to delete resources. A successful delete request usually returns an acknowledgement of the successful deletion. But if you try to rerun the same delete for the same resource, you might get an error because the resource you're trying to delete is no longer there. A good example of a delete request within the FileMaker admin API is the option to disconnect a user. When you do that, you are deleting a user session. Combined with the listClients method mentioned above, you can build your own user control within your FileMaker solution to give some non-full access users the ability to manage connected users. Here's the assignment. For the web service you're trying to integrate with, see if you can clearly identify which HTTP verb each method uses and verify if the nature of the operation aligns with what we talk about in this video. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We publish FileMaker videos every week. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.